How was your off season?
It's good. Yeah, it's good. Just long, super long. It just felt like I've been talking to the guys, and it's just like we can't wait for it to start because it feels like it's been like a year. So we're all excited to be here. This place is beautiful, as you guys can see, and it just feels good being back.
Do you remember where you were and what your reaction was on lottery night?
Yeah, I was in my parents' living room, and I think I have a video somewhere, but I literally sprinted around the house screaming. My mom has a video somewhere, but it's pretty cool to see. I mean, obviously losing last year kind of sucked to go through, but to see it pay off and reward us with, obviously, Victor, it's very special.
What do you think of him so far?
It's incredible to watch. I mean, he does some things that, you know, you can't really explain. Fans would just be surprised by. He just so coordinated for how tall he is, and just a very unselfish player, can make any play, and very comfortable shooting from anywhere. So it's going to be a lot of fun this year.
How about on the defensive end? What stood out other than
I feel a little bit better about getting blown by now. I feel like I like my chances with the guard at the rim against him. So he definitely protects the paint for you. I mean, I came off a handoff like in open gym a couple weeks ago, and I thought I had a wide open three, and all of a sudden an arm just comes out of nowhere and takes the ball out of the air. So it's pretty special. I think he's going to be able to dominate on that end of the floor as well.
What does that do for you have that sitting at the rim?
It does, yeah. It gives you a lot of freedom. You can be a little more aggressive on the ball, maybe filter him one way, send him to Vic, and he's going to take care of it. So it does a lot for your confidence. You feel like you can, you know, be more of a defender and not giving him open shots, you know.
Bob talked about the other day about cool questions to answer in terms of matchups, rotations.
Not from us.
right, not us.
Yeah.
Cool questions to ask about how to deploy guys on this team. Is this team going to look like any that you've ever seen in the NBA before in terms of guys playing different positions and Victor doing what he does?
I mean, it's definitely going to be different. We got a lot of guys that are interchangeable, obviously, with Jeremy. You know, he kind of has an unorthodox game as well where he can play a point forward type spot. And you got Kelvin and Devin, who are both scorers that can play the four. And then Zach, who can really stretch the floor as a five-man. It's going to be really cool to see, and everyone and being in different spots out there at all times, because you never know where you'll be on the floor. And having Jeremy and Victor, obviously, starts with them, and we just fill in around them.
On the offensive end, how has Victor's presence helped you in the way that you like to play?
Yeah, it's helped a lot because I'm just surprised by how good of a passer he is and how much feel for the game he has. You know, obviously, European players definitely have a great IQ coming over here already, and they know how to play. They know what they're seeing out there, and he's very unselfish. So it's been fun to play with, and you throw it to him in the post, and you just cut, and he's going to find you because he's got such good vision for how tall he is looking over the defender.
If I'm not mistaken, you're the oldest player on this roster now. Is that correct?
I think so, yeah. I think it's me and Devonte and maybe Jetty. It feels great, you know, being the old guy. You know, we had Gorgie in here today. Gorgie was in the building, it's good to see him. But it's nice being the vet and just trying my best to be a good leader for these guys.
Tell me a little about that role. It's something you've done the last few years here, but how does that suit you, just being the elder statesman? So
yeah, I mean, we have such good leadership, obviously, with Coach Pop and our staff, and I'm not the most vocal guy in the locker room, I would say. I'd say I try and lead more by example. I'm trying to be early, you know, trying to be one of the first guys in the gym and just trying to be there for anything these guys need off the floor. We definitely have some guys that are younger that are more vocal that can help me along with, you know, Zach and Jetty to be more leaders. So we got a great balance. There's not an ego in that locker room, so that makes it so much easier as an old guy on the team.
For a guy, your point in your career, like the last few years, it got to be tough. You're not in the playoff mix. To have a guy like Victor come in here and maybe boost that, what's the juxtaposition there for you? Like, how much of a rejuvenation is that?
Yeah, it's fun. You know, like I said, these last 2 years have been more development, and it's been great to see these guys' game, progress through the years. But now it's time to win, and that's our goal. And it's great because I'm 31 years old, and who knows how much longer I can play in the league. Hopefully a lot longer, but you just don't know. So it's great to be playing for something now.
You mentioned you guys have a new shooting coach. What's it been like working with him? Has he already started to make an impact?
Yeah, Jimmy's been awesome. He's been working with Jeremy a lot on his jumper, and it looks great. He's a great guy to as a shooter, just bounce questions off of stuff he sees, and he's very, very humble with his approach. So it's great having a guy like that who can just pull up any clip, show you, but not be too demanding. And he's been awesome ever since he got here, and I think the guys really connect with him.
Even with your age and experience, are you still all ears when someone's offering some feedback?
For sure, yeah. And sometimes as a shooter, if you miss a few, you don't want to hear it from the shooting coach. So he knows how to kind of stand his ground, and he's been awesome. I think he's just going to continue to get more and more comfortable around each guy. And I think what he's done with a lot of the younger guys has been great so far, and everyone's loved him.
You mentioned the young guys. I think it was Keldon at Media Day said, we don't want to keep hearing we're young. We want to win. What have you noticed from like the young vets in terms of their growth into leaders on this team?
Yeah, they're hungry. I mean, Devin's been very vocal ever since we got back from Labor Day, early September in open gym, and Keldon the same way. I think they're just kind of sick of being labeled as guys that are on losing teams that put up big numbers, and I think that stuff can eat at you a little bit, and you want to prove that we can also win games here, and it's a winning organization, and that's the culture here. So that's what we're going to try to do.
Have you been taking boxing lessons?
Not really. I mean, I've tried to do the once a week with the team. I'm not the best, I would say. I would say Zach's pretty good, Zach Collins, and then Jeremy's pretty good as well. But that's always a kind of a weekly routine we do here, and it's fun to mix up stuff other than basketball, but I try and save my wrists. I just don't want to hurt myself.
Can you translate on the court from the basketball?
What's up?
Can you translate on the basketball?
I think it can. I think the timing of stuff, it's a lot of core work, and I think that's huge for basketball too, with guys getting up in your grill. You got to be able to like push them off and use your arms, and I think that's similar to boxing, and I think it just makes you a little tougher as well.
How's Victor boxing?
I haven't really seen him, but I mean, I'm sure it's scary. He's got those arms. They got to bring in a couple extra guys for him.